Hello, all you beautiful people of the internet, and welcome to this concert delivered by the RNCM Jazz Collective. My name is Nat Martin, and I'm a fourth year tenor horn player at this college, and I've been taking part in this project. Before we kick off, I just wanted to say a sincere thank you to everyone that was involved in making this happen, the technical team, the music tutors, the orchestral management, and of course, Steve Berry. Thank you so much just for being a massive legend. So all that's left to say really is enjoy.
Thank you. Almost All Blues, my reworking of the Miles Davis classic All Blues, found on the iconic album Kind of Blue. The trombone solo you heard there was by Barnaby Dickinson, and the sax solo by Iain Dixon. Being in lockdown has deprived musicians of livelihood, performing opportunities having evaporated back in March. The very obvious stress and hardship that this has caused thousands of my fellow musicians is heartbreaking. But all of us have noticed that the spirit and endeavour is alive and well, in defiance of the awful facts. Musicians seeking out new methods of making music that respects the need for continued isolation. Recorded video and audio is, of course, the natural medium for us to explore, having lost access to stages and auditoria. The medium is not without creative potential, of course, allowing for sometimes unusual possibilities, where, for instance, location and the spatial environment can be messed about with, sometimes for no apparent reason, just for the hell of it. As an educator, I really miss the opportunity to be together with students in a rehearsal space, sharing and uncovering and exploring the mysteries of music together, listening and responding to each other in real time. Jazz is first and foremost an improvised form, a conversational music where every element of the shared conversation is minted in the moment, a process completely denied to us in current circumstances. So, until a time when we can get back together working properly and meaningfully, the impetus to create nonetheless remains. With the Jazz Collective, we set about remote recording two pieces, endeavouring to wrestle the maximum educational benefit from the process wherever possible. So we had online Zoom workshops so that the students could get help. Trombonists working with Barnaby Dickinson and Jigs Wiggum. Andy Greenwood worked with the trumpet players, and the saxophonists worked with Iain Dixon. Now, the majority of our players have an orchestral and wind band background, so the timings, feel, and articulations of jazz are not their natural habitat. Accordingly, we worked primarily on those aspects. The idiosyncrasies of each player's personal time sense and intonation tuning habits would normally be ironed out in a rehearsal, everyone listening to and adjusting to each other on the fly. This is impossible when working in isolation, so there was quite a lot of fine, detailed editing needed with compiling the tracks to iron out some of those discrepancies. Then it's in the hands of our videographer to assemble all the supplied footage and make something that hopefully has a compelling visual impact. So to our second piece. Bob Brookmeyer and Jerry Mulligan recorded this piece, Israel, using an arrangement by Johnny Carisi. Iain Dixon has expanded that score, scaling it up for the Jazz Collective's resources. There are two main solos, the first of which is by Nat Martin on tenor horn, and the second by Sam Lightwing on tenor sax. We had a lot of fun and perhaps some agonies putting this all together for you. Hope you enjoy it, and thank you for listening.
We'll be right back.